Our skeletons have evolved to be able to resist most fractures, but the extreme loading associated with trauma can create sufficient stresses and strains within bone tissue to cause fractures. Following the fracturing of bone, a blood clot forms between the two broken bones. Various inflammatory mediators are released at the site of damage, which recruit cells involved in the repair process. Following inflammation, connective tissue, such as cartilage, starts to form around the site of the fracture, forming a bridge between the ends of the broken bone. New blood vessels form by the process of angiogenesis, to replace the vessels that were lost as a result of the fracture. Cells associated with these new blood vessels are involved in osteogenesis, or the formation of new bone tissue. Osteoblasts rapidly form woven bone, bridging the gap between the two pieces of broken bone. Once the fracture has been bridged and stabilized, remodeling occurs, in which osteoclasts, together with osteoblasts, remodel woven bone callus to normal lamellar bone and to gradually restore the typical bone structure. While extreme loading can fracture any bone, fragility fractures can occur with less than extreme loading because of skeletal aging and structural decay. Vertebral collapse is often secondary to osteoporosis and is more prevalent in women. Loss of bone mass can be accelerated following the onset of the menopause, which can give rise to osteoporosis. This loss includes early and progressive declines in trabecular bone, which is more metabolically active, along with progressive declines in cortical bone. Cortical bone comprises 80% of skeletal mass. Cortical bone loss, caused primarily by increases in cortical porosity, may contribute to the increased risk of fracture. Another common fracture site is the hip, which is comprised of both cortical and trabecular bone. It is thought that cortical bone may play a greater role than trabecular bone in maintaining bone strength at the hip. Fractures of the hip have been associated with substantial morbidity, mortality, and healthcare costs. These events underscore the important role of cortical and trabecular bone in resisting fractures and highlight the importance of maintaining a lifestyle that helps to build and preserve bone strength. It is also important for older patients in particular to be aware of their personal risk of fracture and seek medical advice on how best to reduce that risk.